Right, here we go then, part three of this video. You may get to this week, or it may be next week before we do this, but I started doing this already, didn't I, on this one down here. You've got to start making these bottles look as though they are made from glass. At the minute, they are kind of just shapes. And we've got to use some of the techniques from here. Now, glass is a very reflective material, and the best way to represent that is not to think too hard, but the edges of the bottle, or the corners of the bottle, they're gonna have little shapes that reflect all of the things that are around them. So this is just a technique of doing little shapes where there are changes in direction. And what I mean by that, it goes from a straight edge to a curved edge here. That is where glass, the shape of glass, would pick up reflections. Glass is also see-through, so if you think about this bottle here, you would also see a little bit of the bottom detail of this glass. It's see-through, so you'd be able to see the edges on the other side of the glass. You might need to do a bit of an edge just there as well, because that might reflect some of the light. So I'm just doing a little wiggly shape there. And again, I'm not thinking about this too much. That hopefully looks a little bit more like glass. Let's just round that off, actually, just tidy that up. Put a little nick on that body spray there. Now this, I would imagine that this sprayer would be like a chrome. So to do that, I'm just going to put some lines down there and shade it like a cylinder shape. Just put a couple of lines across the top as well. A bit more metallic. Let's do this city one over here, because this is a different kind of shape. It's got straighter edges to it. That the shapes on that will be a bit different. So what I'm going to do on this one, I'm actually going to do sort of more regular shapes that show this is reflecting. And again, you can see I'm just doing it where there's a change of direction on the glass. I'm putting in a little shape just to represent a reflection there. Let's put another one over on this side. There's a clear change of direction just there, just a wiggly shape. There's a change of direction, just a wiggly shape. Put another one just below. And again, this bottle here, it will be transparent, it will be see-through. So I need to just do a bit of a line to represent the bottom of that jar, that glass. Okay, let's do one of the ones that I started working on last week, because this is a more of a three-dimensional drawing now, isn't it? So this one here, where's the change in direction? Well, it goes straight up, then there's a curve. So I'm going to put a little wiggly curved line in there. Just do another little one by the side of it. The bottom of this perfume bottle, still transparent, it's still see-through, but it's more square rather than rounded. So I'm just going to put some lines there to represent the see-through. This is the label, by the way, if you remember from last week. So that's where all the details of the perfume are going to go on. This top bit here, I already started putting a texture on the top, as if this was something that you press down to get the spray out. I quite fancy this being out of black plastic, so I'm just going to shade most of that black. And outline that. And you can carry on doing this. And if you want some hints and tips, the reason I've asked Paolo to photocopy this sheet for you, have a look at this sheet here, because this person, who's a better artist than me, has actually done exactly what I'm asking you to do, and done lots of these sort of reflective lines which follow the shapes of the bottles. Okay, and there's a bit of shading to represent the different materials. That's a really nice bottle top there. That looks like it's made out of shiny steel or something. So have a look at this sheet, because this will help you as well as me. Mine are not too bad, but I think this person's really quite cool. Okay, so that's part three of the video. So what have we done today? What should you have achieved today? Well, you should have achieved Lots more design ideas. You should have not been afraid to overlap your design ideas. You should have taken some inspiration from pictures. You should have outlined your favorite shapes. You should have thought about adding letters, and you should also think about adding details to make it look like it's glass, plastic, metal, or whatever. Okay, so you've now got a sheet of design ideas which is getting close to GCSE standard. Okay, that's what you're aiming for. Have a good time, guys.